Every day, every moment of our lives, we make choices. When we wake up, will we listen to our 6 a.m. alarm, or will we hit the snooze button 7 times until we drag ourselves into the waking world? Will we work on that deadline that's a week away, or make tomorrow busier than it already is? These choices are tough, but sometimes the answer can be pretty easy. So what about these choices when they're not so binary? For example, let's say you have 2 extra hours in the day because you don't have to commute to and from work since you're now working remotely. How can you possibly choose, amongst all the things you want to do, what to do in these 2 extra hours? As a college student, I've had the past 2.5 months on summer break, and because my summer job was canceled, I was faced with this dilemma of what do I do with my time? And well, the answer for me came pretty quickly. I was thinking I could work on my art skills again and practice art every single day. I could use my sister's old acoustic guitar to teach myself the guitar. I could put more time into my Russian lessons. I could make videos consistently again. And I could finally work on that game idea I had, and the list goes on and on. And then 2 weeks into my summer break, I realized I'd gotten almost none of these things done, save for an incomplete video script and Russian for Dummies sitting on my desk collecting some dust. I was faced with a conundrum called analysis paralysis. Even something so simple as going to the grocery store and you have your list, but maybe you should go for the eggs last because then they'll stay cool the longest, or go for the seltzer water first so it can stay at the bottom of your cart. And oftentimes, when we have so much choice, we end up making no choice at all. And sometimes this has to do with fear. If I do guitar and art, maybe I won't have time for Russian, but if I lower the time on those activities and put in Russian, then I won't have any time to make videos. We are unable to come to a conclusion, paralyzed by the pros and cons of all these different choices, and then acting on none of them. In order to tackle analysis paralysis, we need to acknowledge the fear underlying it. Perhaps it's the fear of not hitting everything on your list and falling short of dreams, or trying to do something you've always wanted to succeed at, and then a fear of failure. As a result, we end up taking the path of least resistance, procrastination. And it's in our nature to do this, to take this path of least resistance. As animals, our mammal brain, or more scientifically, our limbic system, is wired to take this easy path and stay on the comfortable road. But as humans, the prefrontal cortex, the ability to make complex decisions, we can fight our biology and take the path of resistance and thus growth. Suppose there are 2 cavemen outside of a dark cave and they hear a roar come from inside. One caveman goes in and explores, and another caveman stays outside. Our ancestors are the ones who stayed outside of the cave. And I say this because it shows that fear has a reason for being here. And if fear has a reason, that means it can be reasoned with. Fear is what keeps us in our comfort zone, and we need to push against fear to become a little more uncomfortable every single day. And we can do this by working with conscious intervention. Suppose you sit down and say, I'm gonna finally practice the language that I've been wanting to learn. You go to your web browser and instead you type in NET and Netflix pops up, and well, next thing you know, you're 4 episodes into The Office. Well, what if you took a step back and said, why do I want to take the easy route of sitting and doing nothing and watching TV? Well, our inner antagonist is saying, go watch Netflix, you can do that other thing tomorrow. It's hard, it's difficult, but your inner advocate, if you choose to give it a voice, says, we want to practice Japanese so when we travel there next year, we can really engage in the culture. So will you choose Netflix or Rosetta Stone? Will you spend a few hours mindlessly browsing Twitter, or will you go and work on that essay that you have due in a week? Once you reason with yourself more and more, and your inner advocate becomes stronger with more reasons as to why you are doing things, you will find yourself becoming more comfortable with being uncomfortable every day. So how does this pertain to analysis paralysis? Well, when we're faced with so many choices, so many roads that we can potentially travel down, we freeze up and fear making a decision, whether that be because of fear of failure or feeling like we're falling short on what we're not choosing. Well, just like we can fight fear and rationalize it, we can also rationalize analysis paralysis by using systems to get things out of our head and into the real world. When you have this overwhelming amount of choices, start by listing them out, whether on paper or digitally. Now, this helps because it makes this seemingly endless list of possibilities into a finite list, and reminds you that this list does not go on and on forever. Putting this on paper and getting it out of your head helps clear up some mental space, for when you want to make a decision and finally act on one of these things. Perhaps learning French is on your list and it's a high priority because when you travel there next year for your study abroad, you want to be able to engage in the culture by speaking in the language. Or perhaps you realize that guitar has been on your mind for 3 years now and the thought of learning guitar just really excites you. Pick a maximum of 5 things, and if you can't quite pick, start eliminating. Oh, you know what? That podcast, that can wait. I don't feel too adamant about that. And keep going down the list, getting rid of the things that you don't get immediately excited about or that don't outweigh the other things. And with each elimination, keep in mind that you're not permanently eliminating anything. All you're doing is saying, I'm not gonna do this right now, but later, this other thing is taking a higher priority. And hey, if you still can't make the choice or eliminate things, then maybe let fate decide. Flip a coin or roll it some die to figure out what things you should start doing right now. Acting on one thing is better than not acting on any of them. In doing this, we ensure that there's no looking back later down the line and thinking, oh, what if I did that though? There are no actions that we regret not taking, because the actions that we don't take are the ones we will regret more often than the actions that we do take. If you go down a path and find that you love it, that's great. If you go down a path and find that you don't like it and it's not just difficulty holding you back, then that's fantastic. You've tried something, you've gotten yourself to do something, and now you can move on for something else. Instead of waiting for the world to come to you, you have gone out to explore the world.